touch it.
Thank you very much to the members of the media for responding a short notice for this agent, you know, press briefing. I must indicate that the meeting, the executive committee of the PSL held a meeting on the 11th of October, deliberating on the number of issues. One issue that was important, there was an issue that was dealing with the matters that are affecting the CEO of the PSL. The executive committee reaffirmed that it was adhered to its policies and the schedule of delegated authority, which granted powers to appoint senior management, including the COO, the CFO, and head of legal. Mr. Majabu held the view that he could not accept this. On that basis, the PSL and Mr. Majabu agreed to part ways amicably due to these fundamental differences. Now, Mr. Majabu could not be here to the press conference we met in the morning because he has a case, you know, in Federstorp. But again, you know, observing the tradition of the family, you know, this 1 month of the mourning period. We could have communicated this decision on the 11th, but again, we have to respect the mourning period of the family, and we confirm as an executive committee that internally, also externally, we won't be able to inform the members of the staff. But the last place to the senior management will be briefing a lot of the staff after this. As I speak now, the communication has gone to the members of the PSL, informing about what has happened. But I must indicate that it was an amicable, you know, party of ways, although we regret to have lost, you know, a person of his magnitude, of his caliber, who has served the PSL. But whoever used his services, you know, as a lawyer, because I think he's got a lot of institutional memory with him, still will remain, you know, in the pool of lawyers that will do work, you know, for the PSL in the general full time. So I'm meeting on Thursday as an executive committee of the PSL to decide the way forward. In the meantime, Mr. Henry Dukwanyani will be the acting CEO until, you know, the meeting of the executive on Thursday. Thank you very much.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'll now open the floor for some questions and answers for the PSL chairman, Dr. Kozo. Can you just indicate by raising your hand and identify yourself? Thank you. John Timap?
John Timap.
I don't see you, your hand comes up, I don't see you,
John Timap.
John, can you stand if you don't mind?
You've got a mic there, you've got a mic.
The thing is, I've got a laptop on my lap.
Okay, no worries, stand.
Give me the mic.
I could just shout.
Give me the mic.
Okay, Kozo, if you could just clarify the reasons for that Mr. Majabu is not going to take up the post of CEO, because I wasn't quite clear on the exact reason he's leaving the post.
No. The reason are that he thought, you know, he's got the right, you know, to appoint the COO, the CFO, the head of legal. But in terms of our policies and charters, you know, that delegated authority, that power resides with the executive committee. And in fact, that, you know, he could not accept this. And they felt, you know, he should be the one appointing those people. So on the basis of that, you know, we had to part ways.
Next question. BBK?
Okay, where, this side?
There's BBK, that side.
This side, yeah.
But there's a light, I can't see it because of the light. So I can hear the voice.
Where this issue is not dealt with before Majabu assumed the office of the CEO in your negotiations as to what he needed to do, where his powers extended, who or who he could not appoint?
We gave him federal discussions between us and Majabu. Remember that, you know, the announcement was made on the 30th of June, but he was starting on the 1st of August. On the 8th of August, the executive committee gave me the powers, the mandate, you know, to negotiate the contract with him. And the discussion that was taking place between us, culminating in us giving him, you know, the contract, which indicated which powers he's got, which powers doesn't have. But at the same time, you must understand that Mr. Majabu is a member of the executive committee of the PSF. The issue that I'm raising is the issue of the policies. It's a policy issue, it's a governance issue of the PSF. It's not, you know, a decision of the executive or of any particular person. It's what is written down in the policies which predates his appointment. The policy was adopted in 2008 October. So the matter, you know, is a matter of saying that, you know, he understands, but he feels that, you know, he would have the power.
Okay, next question, ladies and gentlemen. Looks like, okay, Lelo.
Is Lelo there? Good morning, Dr. Bosa. This is Lelo's eyewitness news.
Dr. Bosa, can you explain to us why was this a deal breaker between him and you, and why did he feel that he had to have these parts for him to continue with his job?
Well, I cannot answer that because, you know, I don't know. You know, this is for us, it's a governance issue. And if it's a governance issue, you know, it's difficult, you know, to change, because it means you need to go to the Board of Governors, you know, and I don't think the Board of Governors could have succeeded in us changing that policy. It's not only unique to the PSF. I think a lot of companies, senior management, you know, appointment is the responsibility of the board. So the executive committee, you know, that is the thing that we want to accede to. But again, you know, the reasons I cannot say, because, you know, he's the best person to indicate why.
Okay, Atselani? Lelo, can you just pass the microphone to Atselani? I'll come back to you now, Muto.
Dr. Koza, you just said Zola Majabu is a member of the executive committee. Surely he should have known about the policies, didn't he know?
No. I'm saying that, you know, every member of the executive committee, by virtue of being a CEO, in terms of our constitution, is also a member of the executive committee. Now, whatever happens, whenever there's a member or a new committee that is appointed, you know, the induction phase, you know, you're given all the past minutes, you know, of the past decisions, you make yourself aware of the decisions taken, given the constitutions, the rules of the PSL, the competitions, and the policies of the organization. So obviously, I'm saying that, you know, as a member of the executive committee, I guess, you know, he's aware that that is an issue, which is a policy matter, but the document is there, which is a document that all members of the executive committee.
Omoto?